It is Palm Sunday. Our Lord comes. Yet Jesus does not come as we expect, not as we would like him to come. Today, we mark the end of Lent. And we make final preparations to commemorate Christ's passion. Our work during Lent has been cleared the spiritual path so that Christ in us may become recognizable. And as we hear the story of Christ's entry into Jerusalem, we must reflect on what it really means to welcome Jesus in the week of Passion. Now, we have been saying things the past couple of weeks when Jesus was preparing himself for a time for an entry. And we have experienced some awkwardness in the way Jesus did his work. Just to remind you, we talked about Nicodemus, who was a rabbi, who was highly educated, but something was troubling him. He could not understand the concept of the kingdom of God. And last Sunday, we heard me say to the congregation, there were some Greeks who came who wanted to see Jesus. And they went to Philip, and they went to Andrew. And they said to him, we want to see Jesus. And remember in that message what I said? I said there was a rumor going on. Because Jesus has done something mysterious. Lazarus was sick, and Lazarus died. Mary and Martha called Jesus to come, but Jesus did not come. He came 4 days later. And the body was beginning to smell. And remember the words of Martha, if you were here, my brother could not have died. And Jesus said, show me where he's lying. Now those are some of the things that happened when Jesus was preparing himself to come to Jerusalem. A rich young ruler was also troubled, coming to Jesus and saying to Jesus, what should I do to inherit the kingdom of God? And Jesus explained to him, what you need to do, you need to sell everything you have and give it to the poor. Remember the woman at the well? She was a lonely woman. She had no friends. She went to the well alone. It was something that never happens. Women went together to the well, but this time she went alone. And when she is alone, what happens? Jesus happens. Jesus touches her. And she goes back to the village. She goes back to the people who didn't like her. And said to them, let me tell you something about the man I've met. This is Jesus. Preparing himself to come to Jerusalem. Jairus had a daughter who was ill, and Jairus' daughter died. And Jesus comes and says to the daughter, Talitha kum, wake up. So there was a rumor in Jerusalem. There was a big rumor about this man who comes and heals and touches and changes and transforms. There was a rumor in Jerusalem. This is why when he entered Jerusalem, all the people came. Not only people, not only adults, but children came. Because there was a rumor in Jerusalem that this man heals, that this man touches us, this man changes. This man is different. His teaching is different. His love is deep. There was this rumor in Jerusalem, and this is why they came. This is why they came with palms. This is why they came. And what they did, they took their clothes and threw their clothes on Jesus' way. And they cried out in loud voices, Hosanna in the highest! Again, I went to the Greek again to find out what Hosanna means. And Hosanna means save us. Lord Jesus, the people cried, save us. They cried, help us. And they threw their garments on the floor, on the ground, so that Jesus could trample on them. Save us. Help us. Help us just as you helped others. Strengthen us just as you strengthen others. Transform us just as you transform others. This is what they were saying, crying out loud. Help us. In Strathroy United Church, as we begin this Passion Week, as we begin this week, it seems to me Christ is saying to us, as we throw our clothes, we need to throw something. We need to throw some things that are bothering us so that Christ can walk on them. This is what I'm thinking. And this is my opinion. I might be wrong. But this is what I'm thinking. This morning the message is saying to us as we cry out loud, Hosanna. Save us. Save Strathroy United Church. Like I said last week, so that we can be a church that accepts United Church, save us. Save us from selfishness. Save us from anger. Save us from jealousy. Save us for being too judgmental when you look at other people. You look at a person, then you become so judgmental that you can't even control yourself. Strathroy United Church, this is what the scripture is saying to us this morning. Throw everything on the ground. Throw your anger on the ground. Throw your frustration on the ground. Throw your hopelessness and helplessness on the ground so that Jesus can walk and Jesus can give us new life. And my friends, I'm here to say, yes, He can give us new life. He can transform us, and He comes to make wrong things right. He comes to break resistance, because you see, in this church, we also have resistance. You see, in this church, we also have struggles. In this church, we also have pain. And this morning, friends, He comes. And as He comes, He's asking us to throw everything on the ground. Just throw it. Just throw it. Just throw the bitterness on the ground so that Jesus can walk on it. Hosanna, in the highest. This is what they said. This is how they cried. Hosanna, who comes in the name of the Lord? So this morning, as we enter the Holy Week, the Passion Week, Strathroy, throw everything on the ground. I'm just going to be quiet a moment. And think about the things that you need to throw on the ground.